Hello, Professor Azadgan. I would like to discuss the issue of racial controversy in Trump's decisions. He decided to build a wall between United States and Mexico, but what does he want to do with the border between USA and Canada?
Yeah, excellent question. I think we have to be careful not to oversimplify this issue, the wall issue, and just say it's a racist issue like the liberals are doing. It's much more complex than that. As you and I were speaking earlier, it's about security. It's about one people having a border, feeling secure that the narco terrorists are not going to move up. The criminal element of some of these societies are not going to infiltrate our border. And even ISIS and Al-Qaeda are not going to infiltrate our border. So it's a very complex issue, but I'll try to be very short. Some of the campaign language that Trump used were obviously very racist. The things he says about the Muslims, the things he said about Mexican Americans, the absolute insults. I remember about it was in the August of 2015 when he announced his candidacy. This is what he said about the Mexican people. He said, they're thieves, they're rapists, they're criminals, and some of them are good people. This is outrageous language in a country where the Mexican Americans or Latino Americans are the biggest minority. He alienated that entire electorate. But besides, politics aside and political correctness aside, there's very subtle racial undertones in Mr. Trump's administration, in his rhetoric, his supporters. You have people like, well, I'm not going to say who, but you have this movement in America called the alt-right, which has been supporting him from the beginning. Now, these folks call themselves, white nationalists. I mean, even the name white nationalist is scary. It sounds like something from the Third Reich, but they're really white supremacists. They are, in a way, well, maybe neo-Nazi would be too strong, but they're definitely white supremacists. Now, why are they white supremacists? If you listen to their own language, they want to maintain the whiteness of America. They want to be majority. They are very scared that other minorities, like the Latino Americans, their reproduction rates are much higher than the Caucasian Americans. So they are the quintessential racist because they approach everything from race. And they are one of the biggest groups supporters of Trump. And Mr. Trump did not exactly put these people in their place. He did not exactly alienate himself from them. As a matter of fact, he encourages them. Now, one of the leaders of this movement, when he was in Washington, I believe he was at the press club in Washington or somewhere in Washington. By the way, they have a phony think tank too. They call it a think tank. It's basically it's a joke.
But how is connected with the border with Canada?
Well, I'll talk about that. But I'm just saying, in that interview, they said "Hail Trump," Heil Hitler thing, "Hail Trump, Hail Trump." It was ridiculous. So these are some of his backers. Exactly. Why do we not have the same problem with Canada? Because the border over there is just as controversial as the one in Mexico. As a matter of fact, it's more because it's the wilderness areas are much more, the wilderness, the climate, the topography of the US-Canadian border is much more dangerous than the topography of the US-Mexico border. And we all know that there are many radical jihadists, there are more radical jihadists in Canada than there are in Mexico. The ones in Mexico, the people that migrate, are really the hardest working people. Of course, there will be criminals and narco terrorists and what have you, but the majority, 95%, 99% of them are hardworking immigrants that do jobs that no American would touch. Whereas in Canada, this is a fact. You heard what happened in Quebec, was it?
Yes.
Today with the mosque and everything. That's much more dangerous than this, but like I said, because they want to maintain the whiteness of America, and they don't mind if white Canadian people move down to America. Somehow that border is not an issue, whereas the Mexican border is. Well, to be fair and balanced, there is no narco-terrorism coming from the Canadian border, whereas there is a lot of narco-terrorism from the US-Mexican border. But we cannot avoid the racial elements of this. Now, people in Russia may not, this may not be an issue for them because you may not have those severe problems in Russia as we do in America, because you deal with it better. You guys sacrificed 20 million people to fight the Nazis in World War II. 20 million Russians died to fight a fascist, racist regime. So you handle race issues, at least from that perspective, much better than we do in America. America, really, we are the most racist nation on earth. We killed 10 million Native Americans in a period of 200 years that we've been in existence. Hitler always used to point to America and say they got away with killing 10 million people in America. I can surely get away with killing Jews in Europe. So racism is ingrained in our society. Just and people on the left, they're so naive sometimes. They think just because there was a African American president, which by the way, he was mixed. He was half white, half black. Just because we had a, there's some people that are stupid enough to think just because we have an African American president that racial issues are solved. Nothing could be further from the truth. So Mr. Trump's rhetoric has been pointing out to that. We can't ignore the racial undertones in his subtle language. We cannot ignore people who have been on his side that are very crazy, that are very controversial. We cannot ignore his Attorney General, Jeffrey Session, Senator Jeffrey Session, who used to be an open racist many years ago. Maybe he has repented, maybe he has not. I'm not going to judge him. Only God judges people. But he has a dark, dark record. And so we cannot ignore those things. Again, to people in Russia, that may not be a big issue, but to us in America, racial tension and racial issues are very, very sensitive. You have to understand, this is the country that until 40, 50 years ago still had a separate bathrooms for whites, a separate bathrooms for blacks. Civil rights legislation was passed in 1965 under President Johnson, thanks to the efforts of Martin Luther King. This is a country that up until very recently has a very dark and racist history. We have Jim Crow laws, we have KKK, we have the neo-Nazis, and some of them are very active down to today, and they are big-time Trump supporters. They call themselves alt-right. They're not alternative, neither are they right. They're just racist. And this is very, very dangerous in a heterogeneous, multicultural society as the United States. These people actually, Anastasia, want to have a race war. That's their ultimate goal, is to have a race war. So that's why we have to give this issue a lot of attention for your global audience, especially in Russia, just so they would know what's really going on here in the United States when it comes to these issues that may not necessarily be of very important interest to Russia, but they are very important as far as what's really happening in the internal politics of the United States.
Thank you very much, Professor Azadgan. It was an interesting conversation.
Thank you for having me.